Good afternoon, one and all present here. I have a very pleasant duty of introducing our guest speaker, Mr. Venkatesh Palabatla, Chief Human Resource Officer, GMR International Airport. He has received awards from GMR Group Ingersoll Rand Chairman Award in 2014, 2013, 2009, 2008, and 2007 in areas of role model in CSR areas, inspiring progress, we care, and dual citizenship employee engagement. He is also a certified coach in the field of HR, a certified job evaluator, certified practitioner of personal profiling, and context executive management program. So we feel privileged to have you here. The dice is all yours. Thank you.
I thought, when I was talking to your faculty, I have been given an opportunity to talk something about the business challenges. And it is true that this is the second day for you. And it is true that a lot of guys must have shared a lot of knowledge with you guys. Business challenges, what's going to happen to that? And I was looking for a different point of view, what I should talk about that. Having said business challenges, I'll try to explain to you what the kind of challenge happens to be there, what I mean to business point of view, and a few of my experiences, few of my thoughts. That's my, I'm here today. And I'll try my best not to, bookish language. I'll not teach you the subject over here. I'm here to teach basically my experiences, my thoughts, sharing with you more of provocative thoughts, tips and triggers. That's the background I'm from. So thereby I said, I coined the theme saying that, shape up or shape out. What does it mean to us? Shape up, shape out, I said. Having understood the business challenges today in the market, we need to shape up or shape out. Or ship out also happens to be there. What does it mean? Today business demands you to play multiple roles, multiple domains, multiple tasks. With a lot of knowledge, you need to gear up for that. If you don't gear up for that, you'll be out of the shape. If not so, you'll be shipped out also, out of the organization. I'm representing an organization called GMR, Hyderabad International Airport. And I'll take a couple of minutes time to share my organization values and what this organization means for basically. And it's a proud moment for me to say something about the organization point of view. And when I ask a question regarding GMR means, what comes to your mind to share? What comes to you to share? GMR means what? One is airports, right? Next. Power plants. Next. Delhi Daredevils, business stand. Yeah. Highways. Highways. What else comes to you to share? GMR. If you look at the journey of GMR group, okay, I'll try to give some examples to you so that you can raise in your mind, you can remember for a long time. If you look at GMR Group, they started its journey somewhere in late 1960s with the jaggery industry. They started a journey the manufacturing jaggery and sugarcane industry, please understand. Industry's grown, business grown, moved to forging industry, moved to banking industry, Lavisha banking industry, slowly moved to the roads and highways, power plants, to the airports today. 15 years back, please understand, we never heard about GMR Group. Even Dr. Balaji also must be knowing it today. 15 years back, we never heard about GMR Group. And thanks to his ambition, thanks to his conviction, thanks to his business acumen, today we are leading the airports in India today. That is kind of adaptability, that kind of learning. A few minutes back, Dr. Balaji was telling you guys, adaptability is most important. When it comes to the business point of view also, you need to have adaptability point of view, must have it. And it is true that we believe strongly saying that this organization meant for building institution for perpetuity. There's a little difference happens to be there. You must study in your curriculum also. Meaning of organization, meaning of institution. What difference happens to be there? We are building the organization to make an institution forever. That is our thought process, that is our goal. And second most important thing is that we strongly believe saying that this organization is in a growth till yesterday because of reason that we strongly practice our values and systems, part of our DNA that is. It may be true, 10 years back, it's more of a promoter-driven organization where I'm representing today. And today, it's not so. It's almost all, taken from a leadership team today. Leadership team drives the organization today, though promoters happens in the picture. Reason being that we strongly inculcate our culture and values over there. Like if you take the example of learning and inner excellence, I was talking to one of your faculty a few minutes back, okay? Inner excellence. Today, most wanted need for the professionals working in the organization. not only for professionals, to extent of students also coming out of college. Learning. As an organization, if you not at all adopted a learning opportunity for us, this company could not have grown this extent today. We could have continued to land in only Jagger industry or roadside highways industries or power plant and so on. Today it's not so. So this is one of the DNA of organization this is. I thought of spending a couple of minutes over here, shape up and shape out. Okay? I think last year also I was here for this kind of session only. I made some sort of role activity over here. I made some activity over here for 2 minutes or so. Okay? Now I would like to make it some activity for you guys next 3-4 minutes time. Think that all of you guys are businessmen today, representing various organizations, owning your own organization, and you are entrepreneurs today. I am the customer, please understand. Okay? This activity goes like this. Okay? Maybe 2-3 minutes happens to be there. It's a very simple exercise. More of testing time for you guys. Matter of endurance test for you guys. Endurance test. To prove what extent you are smart enough today. Point number one. Point number two, by doing this exercise, I will attempt to explain to you saying that what is the business dynamics happening in the market today? What kind of dynamics business demanding today? And point number three, it may help you to understand some extent saying that what kind of person I am in today to gear up for the market. Am I clear? And while doing this exercise, it's very simple, of course, it is true. I expect to be smart enough. Be smart. The definition of smart differs to person to person, please understand. So while doing the exercise, be smart enough. That's one. Be genuine also, of course, it is true. And be honest. 3-4 points. Smart, genuine, and honest. And whatever exercise asks you to do it, please perform it. Then it will help you to understand what kind of preparedness you have got today for a business point of view, considering business dynamics. And for me to throw you a challenge, dynamics point of view. I'll do some challenges from business point of view. Am I clear? Okay. So I was telling you, I'm here to share my experience and thoughts only. I'll leave some sort of provocative thoughts with you guys, and you can carry some of the memories from you. And I would like to share a couple of my examples over here. Again, I would like you to reflect the examples of professional life, what business happens to be there. I'll also try to explain to you basically. And way back, for example, I'll start with a story. Nice story over here. When you invite a speaker over here, this kind of professionals over here, they start telling stories to you, saying that I started my life. During my college days, or during my school days, what happens to be there, apart from regular classes, apart from going to school, college, etc. is concerned, and walking to school in a barefoot, part of our life. And climbing trees, you must have read in some books also, climbing trees, part of our life. Swimming, this is history today, history. If you want to go for swimming, you have to go to professional coaches today. It was not so earlier. Cooking, please understand. Go to college, study, go to school, cook yourself and do it. To extent of washing clothes also, do it. Part of life. And this was not a challenge, please understand. Those days, it was not called as a challenge at all. This is part of routine life. It's implied, understood, it stated that it's a part of life to make it a journey in the life. Apart from studies. It's all history today. We don't expect you to do all these things, understand. Today you're privileged to have a nice college today. Privileged to have a, your parents' affordability is there, doing the very well. Keep it up, you must keep it up. But question comes to you saying that, how do I get different kind of experience? And please mind it, you guys not required to go through all the kind of experience what your parents have undergone, not necessary. However, today if you look at it, My life starts with technology today. My day starts with technology today. All of your life also for the technology, am I right? Before going to brushing, before going to toilet, we look at technology. Including my wife, including my kid also. And today various platforms happen to be ready for you to get virtual experiences. My simulation games, virtual experience, you get a lot of experience happens to be there. And you get live updates also. And today, ecosystem is like that, please understand. If I'm not acquainted with all these things, I'll be out of the shape. As a student, as a business, I must get acquainted with all these kinds of things. Not only for you, as a professional life, when it comes to business also, we are acquainted with this kind of things. If I don't acquaint myself, I'll be out of the date, out of the purview, out of scope. I'll be shaped out. I'll not fit to the organization point of view. And reason why I'm trying to tell you is that it's always a competitive nature today. Always competitive. Today you got various platforms to acquire knowledge. That's one happens to be there. You got various platforms to have a skill also to some extent. Skill also. If I walk into any kind of famous malls in Hyderabad today, I can get a virtual experience also. Right? If I want to play cricket, I can play cricket also there. Some extent. I can only batting, of course. I cannot do the bowling and fielding, etc. I can get a virtual experience. If I want to have flying experience also, I can get that kind of experience today. That is the reality of life today. And I'm acquainted for that. As a student, I must be acquainted for that. And slowly move the examples to business point of view now. Today, business also works this kind of transactions today. And we expect to prepare, get prepared for that. This all theoretical thing makes very nice, of course it is true. You have availability of skill is there with you, some extent knowledge there with you, and that's not sufficient for business today. Should be beyond that, something else beyond that. And what I'll do the next few minutes, I'll try to share some sort of knowledge about challenges. Why it is called a challenge, why it is not called a challenge absolutely, how to get prepared for that, and what makes you to be better prepared for tomorrow also. This is the reality of business and economy today, what it is about that. Of course, definitely must have read in various papers, various articles you must have read. It is true part of life again. 1991, early 1991, when you started our career, those days, biggest challenge for us, something called LPG. It's a big challenge for us. Liberalization, privatization, globalization. And industries used to work more of monopoly. If I go to the example, some of the examples, companies like, you know, Aisha Tractors and VDI and Limited, there is a lot of monopoly in the product those days. And that's the time people woke up saying that, man, henceforth it's not going to be monopoly for me. There's huge competition is going to be there. That's the time people spoke something about the customer focus, quality consciousness, cost optimization, and so on. That's only beginning again. Then what happened thereafter then? Global recession 2009. IT industries, because of global economy, recession happens to be there. Third thing again, VUCA world. You must read various articles today, VUCA world. Today, when some of the companies have been shakening also today, absolutely. This is only beginning to understand. And question comes to what next again then? There's so many things likely to be the challenges in our life, professional life, and business point of view also. It's ongoing activity. It's not one time, it's going to be ongoing activity. And please understand, today business, what we not heard earlier, today we've been seeing so many business today. We never heard so many businesses. Today, so many things happen in our hands today. Something called supply chain. There's a paradigm shift in supply chain technology today. Your life depending on that, business depending on that a lot. And I have read some article called, you know, when now, WhatsApp. You can Google and see it also. There's a company called WhatsApp, okay? It used to be an organized structure. The nature of business used to be an unorganized way. Now also it happens to be there, unorganized way, this kind of business. What do? They do laundry business. Laundry. Dhobi, right? It was unorganized earlier, to the organized way. These guys are doing the company turnover of 100 crores today. We never heard about that. So like this, so many companies likely to come future also. This is only beginning. You must have heard about some company called startup companies. So many are there. India is the birthplace for a lot of startup companies today. And a lot of investors also show a lot of interest over that. Some of them may disappear, some of them flourish also. Another thing, disruptive technologies. This is a business economy today. This is a reality. Disruptive technologies. Don't get surprised. Mahindra may come out some sort of a product tomorrow with 3D technology. They are working today. Mahindra. Cloud technology. Today, if you look at HR systems, most of the things are going to sit in cloud technology today. Till yesterday, servers. It's not so in sport. This is all again beginning to understand. And internet, IoT. Mergers and acquisitions, part of the life. Part of the life. You must heard about the various businesses, you know, Flipkart is taken by somebody else, and once by somebody else. These are business dynamics happens to be there. This is a part of life. What I'm trying to communicate to you guys saying that it's all part of life. And the question comes to student's point of view, business point of view, if I'm in a business, what it's for me? What's for me? If GMR has grown up today, it has grown up because of inorganic growth also. Sometime back, I was talking to one of your faculty. When you acquired the company in Maldives airport, Maldives, one of the biggest public sector organization in Maldives airport, acquired the company. It's a learning experience for us. Did you gain some money? Of course, apart from money, we gained experience also. It is only beginning, understand, please understand. In 1990s, we never heard something like acquisitions, mergers, we never heard about that. Today, just like, you know, wearing a new shirt. If you don't like it, take out old shirt, take a new shirt. That's called acquisition mergers today. Real time life, business point of view. An organization shelf life and landscape. Whatever some of the organization we heard so many years back, it's not there today. An organization life cycle also happens very short, unless you diversify business point of view. Like, you know, history today, Kingfish happens history today. Airday can happen history today. And unknown business models are likely to come up today. There's so many startups are there. When it's unknown business means, whatever you heard today, that's all you know about that. What is going to happen tomorrow onwards, we're not aware today. Some other things may come, new things we never heard about that. Like retails, e-commerce, Uber, Ola, technology driving all those things. And question comes to us, what action I get prepared for that? Another important thing is that, no, going ahead, if you look at the business point of view, so many business likely to come up, there are huge scarcity of talent also for us today. A huge scarcity of talent. There is a ready-made prepared talent for us. As a businesses, we invest a lot of time to get prepared for talent also. Another important point is that today, which our organization is looking today, all fast-track growth. They are looking for fast-track growth, accelerated growth. They don't have patience. It may be true, some of the organization must have taken few years, few decades to make it a $2 billion industry. But some of the organization happens to be there, they have made good amount of billion dollars with a short span of time. That is the business speed today. You may do Ashtavadana, you may do Shatavadana, enough that the organization needs to survive and grow it, most important thing. Business scenario, I consider it's more of a mixed bag. When you look at the business and holistic approach, I look at a mixed bag, something like, you know, mixed vegetable curry. I get good things, I get bad things, I get a lot of challenges also over there. So nice things to hear about now, today's business scenario is concerned, make in India, opportunity for us to grow a business to large extent. Best example is Adani, today morning it has come in Times of India also. Adani is getting into the single jet manufacturing industry, never heard about that. They were new only about the power industry, some other industry happens to be, today it's not so. In telecom industry, huge change, industry point of view. Infra company, one of the example happens is GMR group. We started a journey with the power plants, the roads and highways, today we're leading airports in the India today. Globally also, not only India, globally also. Digitization is again business scenario today. And biggest challenge for us today from business point of view is data analytics. We don't know how to measure, how to analyze the passengers' behavior, consumers' behavior. Data sitting with us today. Opportunity for us. And I was telling you sometime back, e-retail, allied sectors. Green growth, likely to create good amount of jobs in the market today. Jobs are there. And good opportunities, what's happening today, business point of view is concerned now. Till yesterday, government organizations means not attracting the brilliant students. Till yesterday's story. Today it's not so. When IIM graduates are joining still government organizations today, better salaries. That is the business scenario. And rupee value today, it's doing quite well. Again, nice to hear again, GDP, though speculation is there, doing quite well, business point of view. And sometimes we come back and say it's a concern for us, we come back and say it's doing quite well also, part of the business journey again then. And manufacturing industry is doing well today. It's picking up quite well. It was not all right last year, maybe last quarter or so. It is quite good. Something called passenger manufacturing industry index. And these are the areas where we need to focus a lot in terms of pleasant challenges. I don't say challenges, I said pleasant challenge surprises for us. When I'm saying business are growing, business are doing quite well, it's inevitable for us to understand saying that a lot of jobs may go off also because of obsolete of scalability. Skills getting obsolete. Because business demands something else different. They may not give you choice for the clapping 6 times, please understand. When it comes to business, they give one time charge opportunity for you only. In the show like this, we can give 6 times opportunity for the clappings. In the business, it's not going to happen like that. It has a once or forever, nothing else. So jobs are not going to be there, some of the areas basically. And workplace stress. Again, I'm telling you business point of view, please understand. Okay, we do have a lot of challenges in business. 60% of the guys would like to leave shortly, quit jobs. 60% of the guys in the organization would like to quit jobs at the earliest. Challenge from business point of view. Layoffs, it's a routine. Layoffs routine, this is nothing new about that. Reason may be, there could be various reasons could be there, definitely, you know. But it's going to be part of the life. Layoffs happen as part of the life. New industry may come in the picture, the technology may be obsolete, and come personal resourcing over there, maybe not scalability is there, they not upgrade themselves also. It's part of the challenge again then. And 60% of millennials are unhappy with the bosses. Challenge. If you look at HR point of view is concerned, what am I doing it then? If employees are not happy with the bosses, what am I doing it today? It's a challenge for business point of view. If people are not there, business cannot run the show. Definitely. Few more challenges we have been coming across today, which you never heard earlier, and you must be reading papers also nowadays, you know. Corporate governance, concern for the business point of view. It was confined to only publicity organization earlier, some extent. Now it slowly spread to other companies also, other sectors also. Corporate governance, challenge of business point of view. Another important thing, political stability and government policies. Best example is that AP and Telangana. May be true, till AP was one unit, one state, it was absolutely comfortable. It is true also, when states are getting bifurcated, impact in industries without a control. It's more of environmental challenges for us. Another challenge for the business point of view, cyber security threats. Today, business runs through a lot of technology only. If you look at my airport point of view is concerned, we use technology extensively. Extensively use technology. And Hyderabad Airport is the first airport in India. We use the e-boarding. No airport has done it so far, e-boarding. You can walk with your mobile phone. You can check in and board the flight first time. And we'll not stop there, understand. It's going to extent of saying that, no, a man, you don't require to carry your phone also. You don't require to carry e-boarding also. Just walk in, face reading technology. You're working on that. Face reading technology, just walk in like, you know, anywhere else. If face matches first for your traveling plan is concerned, gate opens for you. Working on that. Because airports. If you look at companies like Amazon, those kind of things, again, further, far away. So this kind of cyber, when I'm using extended technology, there's opportunity for the guys to hack my technology also. The value for them. So that for business point of view. And marketplace competition. What does it mean to me? Today, every organization look for the customer experience. If you look at my organization point of view, GMR, we look at the passenger experience. When a guy walks into my airport, he looks at the topmost thing, comfort. Topmost thing, they look at the comfort. Next is security and safety, of course. So question comes to me saying that, what is the kind of comfort I'm giving to my passengers while he's in the airport? When you buy a product on Amazon, he always looks at consumer experience. Today, the level of confidence, some of the portals, some of the e-retails, varies to experience. I may have Snapdeal, I may have Amazon, all depending on the organization service point of view. Consumer experience is top most important. And please understand, biggest challenge for today some of the organization is concerned, in name of the passenger experience, in name of consumer experience, some of the organizations, bottom line is eroding it. Profits are eroding it. So business is going through this kind of challenges today, which are within our control, which are beyond our control also today. And please understand, you know, economy today, okay? I was talking to you till few minutes back, VUCA or LPG or recession happens to be there. Beyond that, something else also happens to be there. Today, our dependency on developed countries is very, very high today, as India. If any change happens to be there, a developed country like USA, we also get affected. If Trump says something else, he's going to change some rules for corporations, corporates, identities, a lot of going to be difficult for us. Economy. Also impact on us today. And please understand, today consumer expectations are going beyond our imaginations. As a customer, when I gave some assignment to you today, this while ago, as role play activities concerned, my expectations are very high, very high. And same thing applicable to all kinds of businesses today. Consumer expectations are going beyond our imaginations. And you must get prepared for that. Best example, 10 years back, used to be Citibank. They are the guys who brought the revolution in the whole banking system earlier. Today, somebody has surpassed Citibank also today. You must be surprised, you must have read some articles also today. There's an analytics team sitting in the back-end operations of ICICI Bank, some other banks, to measure the quality of the customers' officers with the customers, customer officers. How do they interact? How do they resolve issues? There's a quality check on that. They make analysis also basing on that. That is the kind of imagination of the customer services today. And basing on this today, business models are getting changed. Entirely getting changed, business models entirely getting changed. Today, as a customer, I am absolutely in upper hand saying that if I don't like product, I can give back to them also. Model has changed. Without paying money, I can take the product. If I don't like it also, I can give back to them. That is the kind of consumer demand today. So reality, what I would like to summarize saying that not today, business expectations not in your hands today. It's not your hands. It's all consumer-driven, customer-driven, market-driven thought process. And what we do as a leaders, we must contribute the value to the business as leaders. We must contribute value. What do I contribute? I'll explain it in a couple of slides. We must contribute to the business. Then business can see some benefits, results, and sustain and improve the business and dividends to the shareholders. And every business looking for today fast-paced growth and its ever-changing business model, nothing like constant today, business model likely to get changed, will change. Best example could be Ola could be there, Uber could be there, and Amazon could be there, Snapdeal could be there, many could be there. Some other things known to you guys, some other things not known to you guys. If you look at the industry like airport today, 70% of activities are gets outsourced today. Absolutely. Airport community has about 10,000 population, airport. Out of 10,000 population, if you look at it, 70% of activities are outsourced. If you look at my own HR activities today, a lot of back-end activities have been outsourced today. That is the business model, henceforth. And no room for complacency. Like Shatavadana, Ashtavadana, you must continue to forever, every day. Not one day story. When you have some turbulences earlier, if you achieve the turbulences, overcome turbulences, you are the hero. Now it's not so. You are continuing to get a lot of turbulences every day, part of journey. You have to overcome turbulence every day as a part of journey. Then only you will be successful, otherwise not so. And this is a rough patch. Rough patch is going to be forever. Till yesterday, VUCA is there, tomorrow some digitization is there, tomorrow some demonetization is there, something else tomorrow. As a competitive market. If you're not smart enough, if you're not able to grab the opportunity, as a business, you'll not have the picture at all. This is part of the daily life. I'll let's spend a couple of minutes over here. So more of organizational life cycle, corporate life cycle, what does it mean? Having understood challenges till now, there are various challenges that happens to be there. One is internal challenges within the organization, something external challenges that is not controlled today. And third thing is that maybe various activities like political instability, customer expectations, part of life. And we look at a corporate point of view. If I compare with human life and corporate life to some extent, okay? When I start the business in the beginning, one is growing stage, aging stage, corporate. Any kind of product. If you take your own personal life, look at mobile phones, some of the products not there today with you. Nokia, Panasonic, must be coming back different issue. They're not there. On a growing stage, aging stage happens to be there. This is more of, you know, example if you take a GMR organization point of view. This is. When I'm growing it, in the courtship stage, infancy stage, there could be mortality could be there, definitely. You may be successful in some of the businesses, may not be successful in some of the business also. Some of the business may die also in the process of journey. And if I stabilize it, I may go to extend the go-go stage. Seems to already understand. It may give the growth stage up, happens to be there. And we look at adolescent stage as organization. or reach some sort of, you know, before going stability, during adolescent stage. That's a very critical stage for me. I'm not matured enough in terms of process point of view. I'm not graduated, of course, it is true. Very critical stage for me. I should be very, very careful over here. And prime stage, that's the time organizations start getting revenues, getting the maturity, customers, market share, and so on. That's the time I may get into complacency. I must not get into complacency at that time as a business leader. And if I move to stability, that's the time I may require to take rebirth also. I should take rebirth. As an organization, I must take a rebirth. If I don't take a rebirth, I will die. I will get into the dying stage. What is the meaning of rebirth? Today, most of the organizations get into diversification. Diversify the products. Diversify the business portfolio. You may take example of Reliance. Could be there. You may take example of even GMR. You may take an example of Murugappa. Or even Birla Company. Adani. Not continue to have the same business forever. Coming back to previous examples, products may die, please understand. Products may die. Because the consumer expectations, if somebody overtakes my products, may die it. And if I want to run the business forever, I must get some sort of diversification. I must get a new business basically. Otherwise, I'm not able to take a rebirth. When you take a rebirth, again start from the same journey again then. You have to go through the infancy stage, you have to go through adolescent stage, you have to get through the even prime stage. This is a life cycle of corporate. And if I'm not smart enough over here, I'll get into aristocracy stage, recrimination, bureaucracy, and death as an organization. And at any point of time, I must wake up myself, I must calibrate myself as an organization, I must get into the graduation every time. If you take the example of some of the companies like, you know, in 3M, for example, 3M organization, they are one of the companies, highly innovative company. They have got X number of patents in this organization, understand. You must obsolete your own products. If you don't obsolete your own products, somebody will overtake you. You must obsolete your products. You have to be innovative, you have to be creative also as an organization. So way forward, what I was thinking for a while, saying that no. The challenges continue to be there. You cannot avoid that. You have to overcome the challenges. Or turbulence could be there. The rough patch is the way of life for us as a business point of view. And way forward, what I'm supposed to do it basically then. As an organization, I must have the ability of future and forward looking. I must look for the future and forward looking, what I would like to do next few years. And sometime back, one of your colleagues asking me, when I've got a strategy point of view, etc., can I define strategy for next 10 years today? I don't think I'll define today, 10 years. At the most, I may think for next 2 to 3 years. As an organization, I must think about that, 2 to 3 years. And change the game is the most important factor. I should know when I'm supposed to use the automatic transmission, when I'm supposed to use first gear, second gear, fourth gear as a business, I must use that. If my product is not doing well, I must kill the product as an organization. When it comes to HR point of view also, look at as HR professional, I must be very clear which process is not doing well. If it's not doing well, how to make it more viable. Today, if you look at it, I mean, some of the HR functions have been outsourced. Over a period of time, you don't get surprised, some of the things also get outsourced. Not only that, until few years back, when it comes to L&D point of view, we may hire consultants. You may hire a PwC, you may hire E&Y, we may hire consultants, as long as affordability for me. Outsource completely. Only shift happens to be there, I will get more of ROI. Every activity of HR activity today, every business activity, they look at ROI. It's the most important thing. And summary is that no, it's about taking next level. To what extent my organization is going to take next level basically. And beyond out of box thinking. Sometime back, when I went for the conference like this, maybe 5 years back or so, people used to think about out of box thinking. That's a little obsolete today. People say beyond out of box thinking. Best example happens against Sony again then. And today best example happens to be their automotive industries. And if you look at the companies like Maruti, companies like Hyundai, if you look at it, they make it a point to make shift their product's life better. You may call about the facelift, you may call about the fashion, or futures, they make it more vibrant. It's a more important thing. And diversification, inorganic growth. Companies likely to grow, companies would like to grow by way of diversified businesses and inorganic growth. I love to acquire some more companies. Instead of investing from scratch, I may love to acquire some more companies. I do that basically. And this is ongoing activity again, calibrate, introspect, gauge, and continue to learn and unlearn. As an organization, I need to have quality of learning, unlearning. I must protect my organization, safeguard interest. I must do that. Another important thing, which is business challenge for us today, more of professional point of view, personal point of view also. You don't spend time with the quality, with the family. If you don't spend time with the family, I'll not do justice to my business also. So as a professionals, we must encourage ourselves saying that I must spend quality with the family also. The way I do with my organization, I do the family too. So I can balance approach for that.
Thank you, sir, for portraying challenges as pleasant and surprising and for educating us with facts and figures, showing us a way forward in the corporate life, and for educating us about growing together and learning in the process.